And now, if you don't mind, we're going to get to the news. A New York judge said yesterday that former President Trump's criminal hush money trial will start on April 15th with jury selection. Well, good luck finding 12 unbiased New Yorkers. He couldn't be more hated if he showed up in Sox gear. In a new interview, former President Trump urged Israel to end the war in Gaza and warned that they are losing international support. Oh, okay. I'm sorry. It's just weird when Trump has the same position as Bernie Sanders. It's like a Gilligan's Island episode where he gets hit in the head with a coconut and he's smart for a day. I'm sure there's another coconut on the way, though. In a new interview, former Supreme Court Justice Stephen Breyer said he's worried the court is moving, quote, away from the Constitution's basic values. To be fair, the Founding Fathers could not have predicted luxury yachts. The IRS announced yesterday that nearly 1 million people did not submit tax returns for 2020. I would have, but if I remember 2020 correctly, my kid was using our printer to do kindergarten. A group of metal detector enthusiasts in North Carolina recently helped a woman find her wedding ring after she lost it in the sand on a beach. And that will be the last time a metal detector enthusiast ever sees a wedding ring. Baze wrote it. In a new interview, billionaire investor Nelson Peltz criticized Disney's diversity efforts. He did like the one he was in, though. And finally, McDonald's announced a new partnership with Krispy Kreme to offer donuts at the fast food chain, because if you love McDonald's and you love Krispy Kreme, you don't have the energy to make two stops. And that was a monologue, everybody. We got a great show for you tonight. She's an Emmy-nominated actress you know from Saturday Night Live and Schmigadoon. She's currently starring in Brooklyn Laundry at Manhattan Theater Club Stage 1. Our friend Cecily Strong will be here. He's a talented actress starring in The Idea of You on Prime Video. His new show, Mary and George, premieres on Stars in April. Nicholas Galitzine will also be joining us. And they are the very funny stars of the hit British comedy show Taskmaster. Their 17th season will premiere in the U.S. tomorrow on the Taskmaster YouTube channel. Greg Davis and Alex Horn are joining us. Thrilled they're here. New episodes of Family Trips, our very own Amber Ruffin joined the show. Check her out. And then Paula Pell and Janine Brito, they are hilarious together. Do give those a listen. Moving on, you guys, every once in a while, I am lucky enough to go day drinking with one of my friends recently. I did just that. Let's take a look. Hey, everybody. I'm at Boxers NYC in Manhattan. I'm here with Oscar-nominated actor Kristen Stewart, everybody. In her new movie, Love Lives Bleeding, she plays a woman who works in a gym. So in honor of that, we're about to give our livers a workout. Cheers.
Boom.
It's time for day drinking with Seth and Kristen Stewart.
Hey!
Kristen, you have been in many movies in your incredible career. Mm-hmm. So we're gonna start off with some cocktails inspired by your films. The first is called the Panic Room. This is a cocktail that would send you into a full-blown panic if you were to drink it. We're gonna start with a Celsius energy drink, then an espresso martini.
Oh, together.
This is gonna give us energy. Mm-hmm. Then a Mountain Dew Kickstart. That's the best of the Mountain Dews.
I love then a tummy curdle. That's the best. That's what you want to start off with.
Yep, yerba mate. And then to prevent a panic attack, a Xanax, but we're just going to use a Tic Tac.
Stop your heart, have a panic attack.
Yeah.
What's
worse?
All right,
here we go. Here's the panic room.
Cheers.
Pace yourself.
Okay.
Your body rejected it. The next drink is based on your work in the Twilight films.
Okay.
It's early in the day, so I'm just going to admit something now. Mm. I haven't seen them. I don't want you to spoil them.
Okay.
So no Twilight talk.
Fine.
From me.
Okay, like I won't bring it up. You better be giving me your blood for this.
I'm giving you a Bloody Mary mix. Garlic. Are you understanding the theme?
Yeah.
Okay,
no,
good.
I'm with you.
Palinka. This is the national liqueur of Transylvania. Ugh, I put too much in.
Oh, man.
And we're gonna stir it all with a
wooden stake. And I'm just gonna tell you right now, this is gonna be a disaster, so don't overdo it. But make intense eye contact with me the whole time.
Oh yeah, except actually, we can never touch.
Oh, yeah, I'm don't just letting ruin you it. Me. Okay. Don't ruin it. Okay. I'm okay with it.
I hate that.
Hey, you played Princess Diana.
I did one time.
And so we're gonna honor that with a drink called the Royals. Have you ever worked in a bar? I guess not.
I've put a lot of work in at bars.
Oh, I see. That's a good way of putting it.
But I've never been paid for it.
All right, so Crown Royal, thematic.
For sure.
Okay.
Purple is
a thing. I think I put in way too much ice.
Yeah, dude.
Budweiser, the king of beers, still follow.
Frothy.
Dairy Queen milkshake. It's coming out weird because we ordered it 10 days ago.
Right.
Disney Princess yogurt.
Probiotics, let's go.
Great. We are so in sync already. Okay. Here's to you.
Here's to you.
Mm. All right. We're doing pretty good. Your career's inspiring some pretty good drinks.
Cool.
I think we have one more.
You have been in a great many independent films. And I think what people
forget about independent films is it's very impressive that they make what they make on a low budget. Mm. So our next drink is called the independent film. And it's just a 40 in a paper bag. Here's the personal shopper.
Oh, thanks, man. Pour one out. I love that.
I feel like you make a lot of movies that are just really good stuff inside a paper bag. And if people want to do the work, get to it. The gem is on the inside. That is
did
so
someone record sound on that? My God, I'm like shivering. Oh, cheers, dude. I'm into
cheers.
This.
There we go. You're gonna do it?
Yeah.
All right, great.
Thank you for having me.
You're very welcome. No, you were saying off camera this was actually Princess Diana's favorite drink.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah. No, she was a real bulldozer.
You played Lizzie Borden in a movie called Lizzie.
I didn't, but I played opposite Lizzie Borden.
Okay.
You just knocked over bottles.
You know, I'm not the cinema writer on this piece. And guess how many we have? Three, here on set. Hmm. Great.
You were in, who were you in Lizzie Borden?
I was someone who hung out with Lizzie Borden.
Who was Lizzie Borden?
She killed her dad. That's
no, and who played Lizzie Borden in the movie?
Oh, Chloe Sevigny.
Oh, she's very good.
She's the best.
Yeah. So you were in the film Lizzie Borden as her good friend.
Maggie.
Oh, look at that. Mm. Nice pull. This is a game called Ask Me Anything.
Maggie. Sorry, I interrupted you.
Oh, Maggie! Maggie was the one, I remember that
we
scene where you're like, Lizzie wouldn't have done that! You guys, chill! Ask me anything. We ask each other questions, and you either have to answer it or do a drink. Do a okay, shot. Cool. Tell me a co-star you refuse to work with ever again.
Oh, it's fun, actually. Find one. Hire actor that I would, like, never work with again. I'm not that much of a little bitch.
Do a shot,
I would do it. I'll work with anyone.
All right. Well, still, that doesn't work. Ooh, all right.
When was the last time you pissed your pants, though?
When was the last time I pissed my pants?
When was the last time you your pants?
Okay, that I can answer.
I could tell.
Yeah,
I was like, something's there.
Look
He went, oh! Yeah.
I went for a run. I remember it was during the pandemic. And I went for like a loop, so there was no bailing. And I got home.
The time is now.
And I didn't make it. And I got home, and my kids were waiting for me at the door. And I believe I screamed, "Get them out of there!"
Get them out of there?
Just like I didn't want them to see. Like,
around
don't me. See me like this.
Yeah. And you just were. You were just.
No, I had.
You were outside. You could have like.
You know what the problem was? It was the winter, and so there was no like tree cover.
Was it just for the general population that you were
oh, that's
shielding
interesting. You're saying if
open
I were famous, would I have open air?
Yeah.
Probably. That was nice that I shared that with you. I
was
like,
just gonna say, honestly, I feel like that's you're a good dude for saying that and for having those kids be bear witness.
Yeah. By the way, they're no heroes. They their pants all the time. Can you place the following order at McDonald's in the accent you learned for Spencer? Spicy McCrispy sandwich, a Big Mac, and 4 shamrock shakes. That was so easy.
Okay. The last time I was on the show was in 2015. What was I promoting? If you get it right, I'll drink. Still Alice.
It was still Alice. Mm. I forgot.
She had Alzheimer's, dude. It's really up.
All I'm saying is I maybe made the best still Alice joke you're ever gonna see on TV. Do the robot.
I'm not good at dancing.
But you are doing this. Does count. You know what I would have called that? The Kristen Stewart robot.
I just like walked right the into that. I go.
Ask me a question.
Explain to me what. I thought it was cucumber, but it's carburetor. What is that?
What is a carburetor?
Yeah.
I mean, I can barely tell you what a cucumber is. Do you know anything about cars?
Can't tell you what a carburetor, I think it's like a processing part. Okay. Like it has to process some, yeah.
It's like the part when you turn the wheel to the right, it's like, wait, do they want to go that way?
I don't think it's about direction. I think it's about something to do with like going.
So like when you step on the gas, they're like, that means
we gotta carburete this. Hold on,
we gotta carburete this. Yeah. All right, go.
Please beatbox.
No.
Okay. Cheers. I won't either. Mmm. Yeah. Okay, I'm gonna be drunk now.
Are you ready to do the next?
Let's go.
No lie. You're one of my favorite actors. I love your choices. You're a wonderful dramatic actor. And because of that, we have written the dumbest lines of dialogue for you.
Cool.
And we want to prove how good you are because you are going to look and read lines you've never seen before, and you're going to move people with your talent.
And white t-shirt.
Yeah, you did a costume change.
This is what it's like to get drunk with me.
So do you always like bring a duffel to the bar?
Only I have clothes? To go on like Seth Meyers bullshit.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
Get in your face because I don't want you to be like, I want you to take this seriously. You're a great actor. I mean it. You're one of my faves. We wrote dumb Ready? Go.
Thank God you're here. Your father, he's had a heart.
All right, take it back. Kristen? I don't want your hand in your face. Just like look at the camera. Just be good. I'm like, I've never directed anything, but like, we be good.
Ready?
Okay. Yes.
Let's go. Thank God you're here. Your father, he's had a fart attack. They think he's gonna pull through, but his butt will never be the same. For no one, he's gonna have to fart through a tube.
Again, more dramatic. You know it now.
Okay.
Now make me believe you're sad.
Thank God you're here. Your father, he's had a fart attack.
And, one more time.
Wait, cut. No, but that was about to be, I was about to pull through back and don't cut me, man.
Okay. I'm sorry.
Don't cut me,
oh
man, because
God,
like
I'm
you
sorry.
Could, because that was about to go somewhere like through the laughing vulnerability. It was about to be like something that I was gonna discover.
Well, then you know what? Stop telling me and show me.
What? Thank God you're here. Your father, he's the last one was so much better. You're such an idiot. You shouldn't have cut me.
All right, go Woo! To the next line. Okay. Ready? Next line. We're gonna.
It was about to bubble up. I felt tears welling.
Here's my note for you on this one. Hold back tears.
Are you gonna like tell me what I'm crying about or just tell me to hold back tears?
Just hold back tears and find out when you read the line.
Okay. Mom, Dad. I'm a puppeteer. That's all right. Can we do it again?
So good.
Do one more time?
Yeah.
Mom, Dad, I'm a puppeteer.
I was so sad for your parents.
They should just get rid of her.
This is, why are you doing that? Because I'm doing that? Okay,
you're
ready?
So far up, you're on the top rib.
Yeah.
Your little teacup is like, I couldn't even stick a pinky in there. Open up, loosen up, baby.
This one and this one, you're angry.
You don't tell me about macaroni. Why did you? I invented macaroni. What the f?
Take it again. You can do this. Look, here's the thing, Kristen. You invented macaroni.
and now someone's trying to explain it to you, and you're mad about it! Come on, Kristen!
You don't tell me about macaroni, man. I invented macaroni.
Matter! Take it back!
Ow!
Take it back! Angrier, Kristen!
Don't tell me about macaroni, bro! I invented macaroni!
One more time, but this time I need to believe it!
I think I'm done. I think we should check the gate.
Kristen, right? That is your name?
Sometimes.
So you were in a movie called Adventureland. You played, I think, Lizzie Borden? So anyway, this is based on Adventureland. It took place at an amusement park. I don't have to tell you, you were in it. So we're gonna throw darts. They're gonna pop balloons, ideally. And each balloon is gonna have a corresponding shot we have to take. Are you ready for this?
Yeah.
Okay.
No!
Yeah, shot glass full of nerds.
Oh, this is like, you're trying to kill me.
Well, no, it's just nerds. You don't have to have a full thing of nerds.
I thought it was just on the top.
I'm gonna have the nerds, ready?
I can't win this game anymore. I've already
lost
it. You are so annoying.
Pickle brine! Oh, I got a mouth full of nerds.
Oh, why'd I do the nerds?
Did you do the pickle brine? Tequila. All right, go until you miss. Oh, water! F*** you. What are you doing? You think you're gonna pop it with your head?
Because I'm a pro is the problem. Oh, embarrassing.
I'm gonna have a shot on Sex on the Beach. I gotta wash down these nerds. Rum!
Okay.
Kristen Stewart, have a shot of!
Get it!
Have
Let's
a
go.
Shot of!
Come on, try
have
harder!
Have a shot of! Have a shot of!
Come on, man!
Have a shot of!
Get it?
Have a shot of!
Woo!
Have a
Not
shot of!
Happen.
Oh my God, what's this happening to me? You stole my mojo! Austin Powers.
Try
me! What the is going
straight,
on?
Straight. You're going to the side.
Prune juice.
What'd I say?
All right, you are a good friend. Prune juice.
Same time?
Yeah.
Let's go.
I should note, we had a safety person make it clear to us we can't throw at the same time.
Let's go.
Yeah, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3.
If we ever make a movie together, this is what it feels like. Let's go.
Jail, a Jaeger bomb.
Let's go.
I haven't had a Jaeger bomb in a really long time. Oh my God, look at you, you son of a gun.
Little feet.
I was in a fraternity. That would have been so much cooler. Put in a sound effect of a pop. Kristen, in addition to you being an accomplished actress, you're also
a lesbian icon.
You are a lesbian icon.
That's right.
Here's the deal, Kristen Stewart. I have a bunch of lesbian accessories and clothes behind us, and I am now counting on you to turn me into a lesbian icon. And what we're now calling, for the first time ever in day drinking, it's the lesbian makeover.
Oh God.
Just do it. do you feel like you're seeing what you need to see?
This is really dated, dude. I guess it's all coming back around though, right?
Yeah, I mean, I'm kind of an expert on how lesbians dress, so.
You almost done, Kristen?
Yeah.
I'm ready to put on my cool outfit. Pick up one pair of pants.
Yeah,
don't send me back with multiple pairs of pants.
We're done.
Are you sure?
Yep, absolutely. Boom.
See you in a minute.
Hey, Kristen.
Announce me.
Seth.
Yeah?
You want to come out?
Yeah.
I think maybe you need a hat, but not like not the wide-brimmed hat.
Okay.
Yeah, and then lower here.
Okay.
Dude, you look cool. Do you not feel cooler than you've ever felt?
I feel as though I've reverted to what I'm supposed to be. Thank you.
Schwing.
This has been
day drinking with a...
I like this outfit, and I feel like it's a
finish
good outfit for me.
Okay, right, wait, one more. Show. Come on, let's go.
This has been Day Drinking with Seth and Kristen Stewart. We're best friends.
That's right.
Give it up for Kristen